A sick Spud!
But is there something else that we've missed to think why there's a Spud bro, Spud man little rivalry?
Potatoes this, potatoes that, potatoes good, potatoes that, but one way back. This is the Flexed Podcast with Mikey, VJ and Miller. What you kicking off for? No holding back, ting. Bang.
Yes, kids, it's the Flex Poddy C with me, V, and the hardest lad in Clitheroe. Besides Michael Bispin and Miller.
Correct.
And we're back in the studio. Obviously, it looks a little bit different. We've not got our black setting and all that. We're just at the back of the studio. Set all these little lights up. And yeah, it's looking decent.
Going for a new feel, aren't we?
We are.
That's it. I know you see the background and all. Yeah. Right on my left shoulder.
Representing.
Yeah.
I'm buzzing about today's podcast, mate.
Yeah, definitely. I know we said last time that we were focusing on just having us three on chatting and stuff, but we've got some big guests in today who we met quite recently filming an episode of Scran Time.
Quality stuff.
So Mill, do you want to introduce the boys?
Right. So these are the famous Preston Spud Bros.
Whee! Let's go.
You know that.
I've got my man here on my left staying low key.
You don't want to be famous.
Ready for the fucking spot of fishing.
Nah. I told the missus I was at football.
How are you boys? Both good?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
What about yourselves?
Yeah, good. Always good.
Good, man. Good. So, I want to dive in with Darwin. So,
go on.
So the missus tells me, yeah. Have you seen the Spud Bros? I said, yeah. You know, neither don't you? Yes, of course. And said, these are from Darwin. I said, I've never seen these in Darwin once. Have you always been Darwiners?
No. So
right, okay.
Harley's Preston.
Right, okay.
I'm Darwin.
What, your whole life?
No, 4 years.
4 years. Right. Okay, so
one more year for citizenship.
So 4 years in Darwin. What brought you over here?
Mrs. mate.
Mrs.
What, recent 4 years? Or are they when you were a kid?
No. So,
4 years ago till now.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
It's about 5 years ago. No, it's about 7 years. I don't even know, man. How long have I been with it for? 7 years, I think.
You said that on the podcast. No. He's going to go, man.
Yeah, I know. Sorry, Nina.
Just say 7 years, we'll cut it in.
Yeah. 7 years, Nina. So, and then, yeah, about 4 years in Darwin that we bought a house, come over. And
nice place to live, though.
Yeah, it's all right. Good investment.
Better than Preston, or not?
Nah, it's wank.
you've moved out, darling. Yeah, you've done a punter, haven't you?
Yeah, I dipped, yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
Had to. It's a shit isn't it? Come on,
I knew we should have sat there next to each other.
So, for people who do not know the Spud Bros, we're going to tell you. So, we've got Jacob and Harley.
Yeah, mum.
And Harley. And if you don't know what they do on TikTok, they recently blew up. Basically cooking spuds and feeding the masses and basically just going live, posting, and they've got a lot of followers from it.
And I think what we're going to do is pop a few clips up now so you can have a look at what they do.
Good morning.
Hello, you all right?
Go on, mate,
what can I get you, ladies?
Yes, bro, what's going on?
So and that's what they do. So how long? I know what I did want to do a chit chat, but I want to dive in, mate.
Yeah, go on.
I want to dive in. Shall we dive? Can I dive in, V?
Let's give him a little bit of background. We turned up a little bit earlier and we were nearly talking about everything we wanted to say on this podcast. Problem, so we want to go straight in.
Yeah, okay, let's go straight in. So tell us, we know bits and bats, but tell us from the start.
Do you want to start, Ollie? Because obviously you were the main guy at the start, weren't you? So
yeah.
And I'll do my bit.
Right, so when we first started, I was in college. I was studying business. First year of college. First year of college, I did all right. I enjoyed it. Second year, I didn't really like it. So the original owner, Keith, he was quite big in Preston. So everyone knew who Keith was. He's been in his family since 1955. And then...
Are you related to Keith?
No. So he was good mates with my dad.
Right.
But unfortunately, he passed away. I think it was three years ago. And none of his family wanted to take it on.
Right.
So he approached my dad and he said, do you want to take on the business? And my dad was like, well, let me speak to me about it. And he said, do you want this? We got this business here. Do you want to take it on? At the time, obviously I wasn't enjoying college. Like I suffer from dyslexia, dyspraxia, and I wasn't good at academically at school. So I said, yeah, it would be great that. So he took it on and then he then was going to teach me how to obviously take over the business, etc.
Run it all and stuff like that. Learn it.
Learn the business side of it. Anyway, the goal was to bring in students at first. So it was just a small goal to work towards. But obviously, potatoes, they're not really sexy, are they? Everyone's like, it's the Mackies and all that. So my dad was trying the social media. He managed to get to, I think it was 60K followers on TikTok. But obviously my dad's like very older generation.
Yeah.
What, were this 3 years ago?
Yeah, so this was 3 years ago. Yeah.
Your dad started the social account.
He started it, yeah. So he started.
What was it called then, obviously?
The Hot Potato Tram.
Right.
The Hot Potato Tram, yeah.
Just doing the same as what you're doing now, basically, or not?
No, it was, my dad's quite cringe. He's like a prop. Do you know, like when you get a proper dad, and he like is embarrassing.
Yeah, yeah.
And to other people, it's funny, but like we're cringe. We're just like dying inside. So he used to do like silly stuff, like don't. He's a legend. You know what I mean?
Yeah, of course.
He's the Spud father.
Yeah.
If you don't know, get to know.
I've actually sponsored that on phone. I think.
Have you?
Yeah. Well, we did the Scrant Time review, and then because we got it gifted, we didn't know how much it cost, and we needed to put the receipt on. So I just went on Google and rung the number.
Yeah.
Thinking it'd be one of you using it. But it was so nice. Like, yeah, no worries, VJ. Make sure it's a good review. Like, what a guy, man.
Love it.
But yeah, anyway, what was it up to now?
Saying that your dad ran the social media.
Yeah, so he ran the social media. It was to try and get the students in. But we got stuck on 60K followers and we wasn't getting anywhere with it. And then go on, explain what you were doing.
So I was, I used to like speak to my dad behind the scenes and like when he first did the TikTok, like he spoke to me, we set it up, we did the Instagram and the Facebook, but I was doing my own thing. I worked for a global company over in Sri Lanka and there was two of us doing it. I was just doing import trading, bringing in containers, selling it to manufacturers.
Mm.
Small profit. So we did well. We did from like a piece of paper, £0 in the space of 3 years. We did like 10 million or something like that. So we did pretty decent with it. Turnover, not profit. Profit's only small. But then obviously COVID was really good. But after the COVID, it slowed down. Like the food was just, the market was just shite basically. Mm. So I spoke to my dad and I just said to him, listen, I'm a bit of a geek. I'm a bit of a, I like to like see how things work. I'm a bit of a...
Big nerd.
Yeah. I'm into like my crypto and sort of stuff. So I had a look in TikTok. I looked how it worked. I looked at like, the algorithms and I was like, you know what? I could probably like try and do something here. So I spoke to my dad and it was a good time. Joining on Arley. So 7 months ago, we took it on. We rebranded to the Spud Brothers and we just took it from there really. And we're here now.
So you just took over the social media and everything basically.
Rebranded it all.
Yeah. So Harley's like, as you say, he's like operations. He gets up in the morning, sets the tram up. I come in, like just double check everything. Then I just run all the socials, the Instagram.
And I'm the guy who makes the potatoes, Peng.
How often do you eat the potatoes yourselves?
Never.
Yeah, never.
We always run out.
Bro, if I eat another potato, I'm turning into a potato. You know what I mean?
So you eat them a lot then, yeah?
We used to.
When we were quiet.
Yeah, when we were quiet. But like, we eat them now again, you know, as a little treat, you know what I mean? You got to treat yourself.
When you rebranded, like, where did all the ideas come from? Was it a change in ideas? Like, a brainstorm or what did you think? I'm going to go with this. This is how we're going to do it. And you stuck to the plan, and it's been up, or has it been trying a few different things to see what works and then sticking with the best?
Yeah, exactly that. So when we first did it, we just tried loads of different things. And I think within the 2 days, we got a video when it hit like 2 mil in 2 days.
Sick.
We were just like, what the fuck's going on? we were like buzzing, oh my God, it's like 100K, 90, just like, this yeah. is insane. Mm. And then, so we just, I think that was like the first like live interaction of a customer coming over, ordering, and it just popped off. So we just stuck to that, and then we just stick to like daily stuff, what we do anyway, interactions, what we do at work. But sort of how I've included it is now is Harley's the more, well, you know what he's like.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And it's good to create the characters.
Yeah.
We see that in the stuff that we do, don't we?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that's, you just got to bring people how they are and just sort of emphasize it a bit on the TikTok and the social media. So I'm sort of like more business. I'm a boring bastard. And Harley's more the funny guy, social life. Do you know what I mean? And doing all that.
Sunglasses at night type of guy.
State of it.
What are you saying, bro?
So you said that.
Let's get the fishing net out.
You should have seen Miller last week. He'd have rivaled you.
No,
you were full. We're all corking. Me last week, all corking.
So you got your first million and you were buzzing. Now you're getting regular. Does it still feel the same, or is it just like, oh yeah, sound, it's done all right, or what? Like, what's the feeling?
Yeah, it's like what our biggest video we got is like 24 million or something like that.
Crazy that.
Yeah.
If you don't mind me asking, were you in the beta program when that one, that 24 million?
Yeah. Yes.
Have you got a figure?
The RRPM is drop loads. We're on like 5p at the minute.
That's bad.
And I think when that video did like 24 mil, obviously people got to watch the full video, so it's qualified views, isn't it?
I think it's over a minute long. As long as you get over a minute long, it's qualified.
Yeah.
Was it over a minute long?
Yeah, it was over a minute long, but they got to watch the full video.
Yeah, right.
So you've got to watch it over a minute.
Skip it, yeah, you don't get it.
Yeah, so if you click on the video, it'll say qualified views.
Oh yeah, of course, yeah.
And that's like, yeah, based on people watching the whole thing. So I think on that was like 7p or something like that. We didn't earn a lot on that.
How much?
enough to make a chip butty, bro. Yeah.
Enough for free Spud.
Enough for some Spuds.
Not four figures.
Yeah, put it this way, we're buying a new tram.
Yeah. And that's all from TikTok, yeah?
Most of it from TikTok, yeah.
We invest it.
So, how much have you made so far on TikTok?
Fucking hell, lad, you're
how much have you made on TikTok?
But yeah, it's because we know what the creativity beta program is like.
Yeah.
Like I said before, we scram time started at £1.40.
Yeah.
We're sitting at 40 pence now, which is a bit, it feels like, fucking hell, why are you going so low? You know what I mean? We don't understand.
What's that mean though? Is that like 40 pence per 1,000 views or something like that?
It's bad for people that who are actually just doing content though. Mm-hmm. Imagine if they're
constant content. Yeah,
that's it. That's a living.
It's
right?
just
Imagine.
What advertisers want to, like, say if you're doing talking about finance on TikTok, your CPM
goes up.
It's huge.
Businesses and finance.
Yeah.
It's big.
I didn't know it changed. The numbers changed all the time. I thought it would be the same for everyone.
And it seems like that since you've been doing better, the money's gone down because they don't want to pay as much. But it is good to talk about figures sometimes, because you get a lot of people in the general public who look at you, oh, they must be making loads of money. Do you know what I mean? But they don't really know.
We look at it all the time. Yeah,
but then nobody really knows. To us, 25 million views, or they're coining it in. But then you see more and more, and the general public will think, yeah, they're smashing it, but you don't really know. Nobody knows.
Well, the creativity program, they pay out at the end of every month. Have you seen what they're going to be paid out for you?
What for this?
This what they're going to pay out this month for Spud Bros?
You don't want to say it.
Because they pay at the end of every month, and you get to see the number before they pay.
It's like 30 days, isn't it?
Every 30 days,
and it's like 2 months, isn't it? So it's the end of the month plus another month. So it's like 2 months.
Oh, yeah, so you're a month behind, correct? Yeah.
Yeah.
So what are you looking
He's
at?
He's asking too much. You work for the tax man.
Look, your bank details and all.
No, it's an open concept. You know why I want to, because when you see these TikTokers such as like Bebo, he calls
them. Yeah, they make out like they're making so much fucking money, but a lot of them lie about
it. But with Bebo, he said he earned 10 grand a month, and looking at his numbers, I know that his main thing is food and he's probably on the same CPM as us.
Yeah.
So for him, it felt like a bit of a lie because I know what sort of CPM he would be on.
Yeah.
So that's, and he was openly saying, yeah, I mean, I'm 10 grand, 10 grand. But
the only difference with people like that is when you're in the public eye and you make it, then people want to do stuff for you and you get in places for free, you get clothes for free, you can live the life with not necessarily having the money. You know what I mean? Like, have you ever had anybody approach you for like brand deals and offer you stuff? And
Yeah. We've got a few brand deals now. Like we've got like KP Infinity who supply the trays.
Oh yeah, it was, I think we see. Did you do an ad for them?
Yeah,
that was cool. Yeah. Man.
So they go through a TikTok agent, and then obviously they go through them, and then TikTok agent comes to us, and then we just do it that way with them.
Yeah.
We partner up with like Sneak Energy.
Oh, sick.
We're an official partner with them.
Sick.
What was the bag on that?
Free energy drinks for life.
So what you gotta do? Just put the energy drinks on.
Yeah,
on tram.
Just a few videos. Just
promo like, on a little bit.
What? So when they offered you it, did you see? Oh, that's a good number. That did you think that's worth it?
We just get free energy drinks from them, and then hopefully
we didn't get paid by them.
Yeah, it's
really.
No.
Okay, so
it's like
what for life.
Yeah, so they just said, whatever supply. You need, just...
You could have put a few bottle cans on the...
All right, so you can get free drinks off them, and then when you sell them, you get the money for them, yeah?
We can do that. So they have said, we'll give you a code, and if anyone buys from that, you just earn commission off that.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Commission, at the minute, commission's like, it's about peanuts, you know what I mean? Yeah, it's like affiliated marketing.
Yeah,
more. But like we're doing, like TikTok's good. TikTok is probably the best platform to use.
Yeah, 100%.
At the minute, I mean, you've got... They call it TikTok brain, don't they? So it's like when people like go on it and they scroll through a video, you've got to catch them within that first 3 seconds.
Yeah.
Otherwise they just scroll past. Well, that's what we try to do. With like the interactions and all that. And obviously you've got like the marketplace on there. So we've got like the Spud Bro merch on there.
Yeah,
now.
About that. Where's ours?
Who designed it?
Could have done me a nice hoodie, me today.
Yeah.
So we are working with another TikTok agency called Wear It.
Okay.
So the way that they work is, it's pretty sick to be fair. They're an agent for TikTok. They do all the graphic designs for us. So they did all this. They did design for us. And if we've got our products on our TikTok showcase.
Mm-hmm.
If anyone orders, it goes straight to them. We earn commission off that.
Nice.
And then they send it out. Yeah. They deal with all the queries.
So you're just getting the money and they're doing all the hard work, really, when you're being the face of it.
You're just front face. Like, we're just making like sales, you know what I mean?
So they made the logo on that, yeah? Did you not give them like a brief idea of what you wanted it like?
Yeah, of course we did. Yeah. We just said like, we want this. Can you make it like that? And they were like, yeah, of course we can.
Do you get to see like how many units of stuff get sold, obviously?
Yeah.
So you could be in a position where, right, let these set it up and now it's doing well. We're turning over big numbers. I'm going to start doing my own.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah, you could look at it in that way.
Yeah, but it's all about like, for me, it's all about relationships.
Yeah.
You've got to, like with Sneak, do you know what I mean? Like we're trying to do like good relationships with them. It's very new. I'm going to do some videos, do you know what I mean? And then hopefully down the line we can join on like campaign and then that's when they like start.
Yeah,
that's it.
Do you know
that's
what I mean?
Mm.
And then you can sort of bring your own drink out with them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So Sneak X.
Yeah.
This guy's listening to our conversations.
We've got ears on the inside.
I've been outside back at Van at like dinner time when you're just chilling and chatting.
Not energy drinks.
Yeah.
Going back to this, the merch sale, because it just made me, because we, for Scranton, we use Printful.
Yeah.
And how you explain it sounds very similar. But for us to... What are you doing?
Is that making noises?
No, what are you doing over there?
I'm just messing with this fucking wire.
Oh, right, I thought you was on your phone.
Shit. No.
Oh, God.
Go on.
So we use Printful,
which
sounds very similar to what you do with that company. But the profit margin is terrible.
Yeah.
So like say if we sold a Scranton hoodie, we're looking at £2 profit. And we sell the hoodie.
That's on a 60 fucking pound hoodie as well.
Yeah, they're not cheap. So then we feel bad to our fans who are paying.
And then people don't want to buy them because they're like 60 quid an hoodie.
They think we're
like
doing them over.
Yeah, but it's not us.
So it's down to the materials because they print and ship and stuff.
I'll get you, I'll send you a contact for Wear It.
Right, so footprint for that. Welcome, man. Do me, I didn't. And you know what they do as well? When you make
and
a
it's
sale,
shit.
Yeah, I know.
Is it not shit?
Yeah, it's a bit wang. So what's even worse?
That's why none of us are wearing it.
So when we make a sale, they buy. It's like, okay, someone's purchased. Now Flex, the company, gets charged straight away for the garments, and then at the end of the month, we get the profit. So they basically, someone's taking 30 quid to give me fucking 32 quid back at the end of the month for a hoodie. And it's the only one way that's stress free, because all the others that we tried another one and they were like messing orders up. And
where do you sell it on TikTok or?
TikTok and our website, Scrantown website and Instagram.
No, so where it is sick, honestly, like they even bought a domain called thespudbrothers.co.uk on their own behalf and said, I bought this domain for you, put it onto your Instagram and your Facebook, and we've also done a tracking solution. So literally any orders that come through, send me an email, I can see how much we sold, and it all goes through to them, and that's through the website as well.
Are you getting decent profit margins?
Yeah, we get about 40% on that.
Oh my God, Basil's getting 2 quid on that.
You're not even worth it.
Close the shop, man.
Fucking hell. Yeah, send us that then.
We'll sort you out.
New Scrum Time merch coming soon.
Yeah, we've made it.
Because look at how clean the logo is, man.
And yeah, always it's like faded out, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's the nice, man. I got another one under here that they've done as well. And t-shirts, it's like...
I've seen the videos of them.
Overhang as well. And like proper good quality. Yeah, man. So
they look really good.
Yeah, we'll sort you out.
Nice one, man. Nice one.
You've been getting decent sales in that, or not?
It's
a bit slow.
It's a bit slow because obviously on the TikTok we've had a few technical issues where we got banned twice.
We haven't really promoted it either.
Yes.
What are they banning you for?
It was like impersonation of another person or organization.
What, Spud Man?
And yeah. I don't know, man. Do you know what I mean? It's just people reporting us, and then we just. Like, because.
You get them, though. Weirdos. We get banned every time we go live, don't we?
Yeah, because he's vaping his nut off.
No wonder, man.
I don't vape.
The app's 13 plus, and he's like, oh, and he's effing and jeffing. You can't beep his effing and jeffing on TikTok. But what you said about Spud, man. So we see there's like, I don't know if it's beef, but it doesn't look like it's beef from yous or him.
Yeah.
It's like the viewers are causing crap. Yeah. But is there something else that we've missed to think why there's a Spud Bro, Spud Man little rivalry?
Man, you've hit nail on the head, to be honest. It's like, I mean, when my dad had the business, Ben and him were on the phone every day. Do you know what I mean? Bouncing ideas off each other. He's even come over to the tram. Like, I don't know if you've seen a few videos. He's come over, he's done it.
Oh, so you know each other then?
Yeah.
Spudman.
I taught Spudman, that's how you
That's what because I was going to say, who came first, the frogs or the man?
Yeah. Well, like, even on our videos, when we did the review for them, they were commenting about Spudman and that, weren't they?
Yeah.
There's some mad comments like, you went to the wrong place. We're like, what do you mean we went to the wrong place? We went to...
No, the deal is, bro, if it rings on a pod, you better answer it.
Nah, it's my mum. I don't know answering that. She's an absolute nutcase.
Yeah, so there's no hate between you and the Spud.
It's like Ronaldo and Messi, isn't it? You know what I mean? That we respect each other,
yeah,
but we need that rivalry.
Yeah, it's good.
There's no hate to each other at all, but that rivalry is always good. You know what I mean? Like,
listen, anybody doing the same thing or similar... Yeah. People are going to get in between, or you're copying such
person. But that's the thing these days. You're not allowed to do something that somebody else has done, but why? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. I think that's it though, isn't it? Because he's been doing it since 2020 and he was the first person to do the jacket potatoes. And obviously we've come along and it's just like his like fans and other fans are just...
Yeah, but you've done it for... 60 years, not you guys, but that tram's been so just because he filmed it first, you're not allowed to film what you're doing. Do you know what I mean?
It's a new age movement.
Yeah. Spud
fans have been going years and years, haven't they?
It is what it is at the end of the day. We do our thing. We're concentrated on doing our thing.
We're doing well.
We're not arse about it.
There's enough Spuds for everyone.
Exactly.
There's one coming in Darwin as well.
The Spud,
what's it called? Spud House.
Spud House
coming in May, Spud House.
Interesting.
Right.
You know him?
I don't know him personally, but I think Harvey does over there. Young Harvey.
We'll bring Harvey on the camera a sec to say hello.
Spud Sid.
So, what's Harvey to you? Is he a friend or family?
So, have you ever watched Toy Story?
Toy Story. Yeah.
you know, he looks like Sid from Toy Story. That's how we call him Sid.
Yeah. So Harvey's our bitch anyway.
Is he a family member or?
Yeah.
Little bro.
Yeah, no, we love Harvey. We love him.
He is Martin. So Nina's daughter, Millie, yeah, is her boyfriend's twin brother. So the reason I brought him on because he reminds me of Harley.
He's okay. Ace. We love him. He's
a little legend, isn't he?
So are they paying you well?
Payment spuds.
How much did they make off that 25 mil vid?
He wasn't here then.
I was watching the live today.
Right, get him off.
And he said, I would go to the toilet and you had 12 spuds to do or something. I was watching it. And then I come back after about three. He was like, hey. Funny, man.
No, he's a good lad, though. Yeah. Like, he's sound.
You work hard, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, he works hard.
You all graft, though. Yeah. Aren't you? Fucking non-stop.
Yeah.
Madness.
Speaking of grafting and non-stop, that other day, Vijay, what did you mention yesterday?
About that 36-hour...
Oh, was it you?
Yeah, 36-hour stream you did with the charity do or something, were it?
Yeah, yeah.
That's it.
And the guy flipping the tyre and all that.
Yeah, so big up Bill, man. He's a... beast. Have you seen him?
Yeah, he's a beast.
He used to be like a pro boxer and he's just like got fighter's mentality. So he did like 10,000 flips on a 226 kg tyre.
He's done a sleigh from Edinburgh. So he pulled a sleigh for Edinburgh to Blackpool. And he's doing it. Actually, I don't know.
No, you can't say it.
Oh, what's that?
No.
Where's he taking it? He's not telling us anything. Not telling us how many money or anything.
Next year, he's doing it from his bollocks.
You need to get him to pull the tram.
That'd be
sick. Some good publicity.
Lots of serving spuds. Hurry up, Bill.
So obviously with the TikTok thing, there's a lot of people trying to do the same thing, whether it's not spuds in general, but trying to make it on TikTok.
Yeah.
And you're two of the lucky people or three of the lucky people that have, like, what have you done different and what's your key to success? Like, how have you got to where you are? Is it luck? Is it hard? Like, talk us through it.
Go on, Ollie.
I think it's hard work. But without Jake, I couldn't do it. And I think without me, Jake couldn't do it.
Yeah.
So we have this thing where he's a serious one. And I'm the dick, basically. Yeah. And it works.
Balances. You know what I mean? Out.
And you just gotta like plow content out. You just gotta work really hard.
Yeah.
Yep. Plow content out. And eventually you will start to see progress. It might take years, but eventually you will. So I just say, like, just carry on working hard, never give up, never give up on your dreams, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
And eventually it will come to you. As long as you've got the right mentality and you're not a dick basically about it and
you've got to be a sound person.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
you know what I mean? Yeah. To come across.
Yeah, like, you've got to be like likeable.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Sick.
You ever step on each other's toes in travel?
Oh, man.
End up nearly scrapping.
All
and
that.
Yeah. Yeah, he runs off.
Get away, you know, Ben.
Harvey's like in the corner, like,
spuds are ready.
Right, shovers next. He's like, cheese and beans.
Like, is it hard to, like, obviously, because you're on live most of the day, like, watch what you say. Yeah. You know, you're conscious of it all the time, or is, you're like, look, you can't be swearing or.
At first, it was. But you start to get used to it, you know what I mean? Sometimes you slip up, sometimes you can get your emotions take over, can't you?
Yeah.
But I think we're relatively good on live. I think we say what we need to say. Like,
and it's one of them, like, right. Everybody has bad days. If you go to work, you're having a bad day and you've got the whole of TikTok watching you, it's hard to...
We're like brothers, all three of us. If anyone's having a bad day, we'll look after each other, you know what I mean? So it's like... Today, like, I've been in hospital, like, staying with my missus, and I said, like, I'm not really feeling it today. Kind of like going up, and they look after me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like when Harvey's upset, we'll put him in the back, we'll have a chat, and we'll say, you just chill here. Like, we look after each other.
Yeah, and that's what it's about.
So that's what I mean. So that's why.
Yeah, he nearly set his fucking.
Oh my! Yeah. I went to him. Harvey, will you just put the boiler on, bro? Yeah, yeah. he's pressing in the gas for ages, like that. And he lights it, goes,
poof. Oh, big, oh, yeah, yeah.
He goes, he didn't scream or anything. Looks up to me and all his eyebrows singed. And I started absolutely pissing myself. He walks out to Jake. He goes, Jake, I'm blind. And then Jake comes in. He goes, he needs to go to A&E. He needs to go to A&E. I come out. He's fine. He's just got a singed eyebrow. Anyway, he put a paper towel over it. He was ready. But right. I couldn't stop laughing. It was a bit tight, but.
Who's the most famous person? Is that one of your spuds?
Zaz Miller.
Yeah.
Probably Ollie Ball. Ollie Ball.
Bolton lad, another Northern kid.
Yeah.
What about that? I seen a video of a week. Preston captain, or
oh, Brown. Oh, Alan Brown, yeah.
Yeah.
Big
yeah.
up the Brown.
Yeah. Up the Whites.
Oh,
yeah.
Skipper.
Barbie, oh,
up the Whites.
Hey, that boo.
Get him off.
What is that?
Fucking hell, that's dusty.
We're going. We're getting promoted.
Yeah, rough out, chat.
Nah, we've got a few people are coming down who are bigger, but
I'll change the question. Like, what's the furthest someone's travelled?
Well, mate, Australia, Amsterdam. Yeah. Someone came from Amsterdam just for a bag of spuds. just a bag of new potatoes
cooked.
Yeah, just with salt.
Now, what happened was he saw us on TikTok and he was on the live. He said, "I'm coming down from Amsterdam." We were just like, "Yeah, whatever, bro."
Anyway, he must have been baked at the time.
Matt, he was on serious munchies.
It was like 3:30 on the dot when we closed. He come. He's like, "Yeah, can I have a jack of potato, cheese, and beans, please?" Like. Mate, we've run out. I've come from Amsterdam. And I was like, we haven't got anything. So he's just like, I'll have a bag of spuds then. It wasn't like, oh yeah, come back, we'll sort you out for anyone. So we was just like, shit, what do we do? Should we just have to give him a bag of spuds?
It was sound.
Get him at Travel Lodge and tell us to come back tomorrow.
Yeah. What's the maddest experience you've had? And is it on video, or have you ever made a video where you thought, I can't put that out because they was really mean or nasty or anything then like that?
You're in Preston City Centre, mate. Everything's mad. We've got this woman called Kelly who sings, right? And she just sings in the same pitch every time.
She good?
No.
Yeah, but she's a Preston legend, though.
But yeah, we look after everyone in Preston. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, man.
Yeah, speaking of that, I seen that you're doing like a workshop. Is it in Preston? For something. Tell us a bit about that and why it's important to like give back.
You've got to like sacrifice things as well. Do you know what I mean? And always give back to your community because we've been blessed. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. With what we've done. So we're just like, we'll share it. And we just want to like, just share our knowledge and like, we're comfortable what we do now. Do you know what I mean? And just share knowledge and get people oppressed in.
And you've lived it and you know the.
Yeah.
And like you were saying about where you're from, it takes the community first to boost you up. You know, because if Preston weren't behind you, then you wouldn't reach anywhere else. Same with us, we grew big in Darwin first with Scrantime, doing all the local ones and got a good following. And then that helped push it to all the other places. But I think it's sick that you're doing stuff like that. And it inspires people as well. Because everybody wants to be a YouTuber or a TikToker these days. Don't they? So at least it's showing the kids it can actually happen. And you're giving them a route as how to do it, as opposed to just...
Yeah, so it's like in the company, you have like a mission statement, don't you? So our mission statement is to inspire the younger generation using social media from a spud van. That's literally it.
And if you can do it in a spud van, you can do it anywhere. If you can make that interesting.
Yeah, exactly.
Like you said, they're not the most beautiful of food, are they?
Yeah, they're sick. Awesome.
They are good, lad.
The one that you bought was unreal, man.
Nah, but I remember I've done the review, watched it back, and I'm saying I've got cheese and beans, and then it...
No cheese.
There was no cheese on it, lad.
There was no cheese.
Why
did it look like?
I swear you didn't ask for cheese.
No, he said, do you want cheese? I said, nah, just give me some of that white cheese.
Yeah, yeah.
Also, there was no cheese at all.
I was going to say, why did
it
you...
It felt cheesy.
I was going to throw him under the buzz and say, why did you not give it a 5? But he's got a little out there because you didn't put the cheese on it.
Exactly. No, to be honest, that was probably the worst spot of the day. I'm not even joking.
There was a few comments saying it was burnt.
Yeah,
and that.
It was.
I finished it off.
Did you?
Yeah, because we have to...
Class though, weren't it?
Yeah. Probably, I've never had a... Obviously, I'm used to like jack a potato in the microwave and then you put your beans and cheese. Shit. I'm used to that.
Yeah.
So when we had yours, it was like, okay, I understand the hype now. It is tasty as fuck.
Yeah, it is. That sauce is good, lad.
Yeah. Tram sauce.
Really good, that.
What's in it?
Garlic chili mayo it is.
Nice. Yeah, nice touch. Is it a family thing or is it just...
Just an idea that we did.
Trial and error, isn't it? Yeah, like, what is it, you with your minced beef, is it? Charlie made one and it was so hot that you couldn't eat it or whatever, like trial and error sort of thing.
Yeah, well, you got to have spicy chili, don't you? Chili's got to be spicy.
That's spicy stuff.
Yeah. What? I mean, you'd be suffering the next 2 days, but it's worth it, bro.
Name me something like... The ultimate spud you could do. If you had all the ingredients in the world, a mad spud that is delicious, and obviously you can you have to consume it. It can't be just a mad one, but tell me the ultimate spud you could make if you had all the ingredients.
Mine would be probably like mozzarella cheese, right? Barbecue, like Hunter's chicken potato. You know what I mean?
You like a stoner munch.
They're coming from Amsterdam again to get it.
Yeah, you looked very impressed when I said that.
So Hunter's chicken and that's it.
Hunter's chicken, cheese, potato. I like barbecue, warm barbecue sauce. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I do barbecue beef brisket. Mac and cheese on there.
Oh yeah.
Sour cream. Sounds good.
Right, I want to change my
And you know, like, potatoes are a big part of Christmas dinner. Surely you could do a Christmas one with turkey and all that. Yeah. Because they all have mash and roasties on, don't they? So why can't you?
Yeah, we had jacket potatoes, cheese and beans on Christmas. I think we're joking.
Yeah, there's a video of it. Yeah.
I didn't see that. Oh, look at our TikTok.
And when it's the birthday, they blow candles out of the spot.
A sick spot!
Like what? That's the intro to the whole video.
Love it.
Yeah, but this is what I was thinking today. Like, what's the difference in spuds? Because there's loads of different spuds, isn't there? Like, what makes a good spud? What makes a bad spud? And like, why are yours different to the ones we get at home? And we're going to bring one today. I went everywhere for one and they were all like small or shit. So I thought, I can't be rocking up with one of them. I wanted like a nice big jacket potato. Big fat one, yeah. And we're going to go spud me.
So what it is, when you, do you know the spud you buy from supermarkets?
Yeah.
You can keep spuds up to 2 years if they're in a cold, dark place.
Right.
So what retailers tend to do is contract spuds for the year, so the price doesn't move, and then the farmer will keep those spuds and then pack them.
Right.
Some spuds that you get in retailers might be a year old or a year and a half old.
Right.
Mad.
We buy from a local farmer, big up TGS, Rachel.
Big up TGS.
Is it TGS?
TGS.
Gauze, I think.
Oh, yeah, get TGS. It right, lad. Get it right.
TGS is...
TGS. Yeah, they just changed the name. So, okay. Gauze, Rachel.
Gauze.
Rachel. She's a big supplier of spuds. So we just buy direct from her and she gives us fresh varieties.
Good stuff.
The spud plug.
Is it unlimited supply or what?
Yeah.
Like how do you know how many you need for the day? Like how many do you go for in one day?
Well, we just buy, man. We just keep buying. And this guy here just keeps wrapping, and then he's topping up.
Have you got a record number of spuds in a day?
Friday was mad. So we did the iftar for the Muslim community. Yeah. And then we obviously did the 36 hour.
We did about 30 boxes and there's like 60 in a box.
Yeah.
60 in a box and we did 30 boxes.
Quick, get your calculator out.
Quick math. You're good at math, Mill. What's the math on that?
I'm bollocks, 12.
No, what's that number?
15, so that's about 1,500 boxes that we... 1,500 potatoes.
Spuds in one day.
Yeah.
Our portions are 1.5.
Yeah, so I seen that.
Is that like a regular thing or is that something you do specifically?
No, so that was just like the... that was
1,500, innit?
Yeah, I think it was actually like 40 boxes we did or something. We didn't actually count.
Yeah, because we went back, didn't we, to get more stock. Yeah,
so on the Friday night, because we did like 11:30 a.m. till 4:30 in the morning. It was a 3.5 hour queue. It was
mad.
It was insane.
This is what I was going to ask. Like when we turned up, when we planned it, we thought we'll go a bit later so it's quiet. We got there and it was still rammed. Is that from the moment you open? Is it like that all day?
Yeah.
You don't get a minute.
No.
And how long has it been like that for? few months.
Since we've rebranded, 7 months. Like.
Since the Spud Bros came.
Yeah. Mad.
So Spud Bros has been going for 7 months.
So I know we've talked about the TikTok money. The business itself without that must be doing all right.
Yeah, yeah. Good. Yeah, yeah, it's doing well.
What's the numbers?
We make a chip by the end of the day.
Do you think it's going to last?
No, the hype won't last.
Because it's like times, isn't it? People just go with the times. Something else will pop up and be the hype at some point. Do you think it'll...
We're always looking to...
Big up Burton and Bennett. Have you seen that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Is that what we want to do?
We need to go and see him. Yeah. See them, sorry.
But yeah, we're always looking to different stuff. Like, I've been to my boxing, my MMA, so like sponsoring gyms there and like... we'll probably do content with them, stuff like that. Like, we're always like trying to stay one step ahead because everyone's loves boxing now, don't they?
Would you jump on that HS boxing thing?
No, probably not the HS one, but I'd definitely do the mitzvah.
The HS one's messy, isn't it?
Yeah, the HS one, but that's like a stepping stone.
You don't want to do a press conference for them, do you?
Madness.
I'd rather do it professionally, you know what I mean? Not like just set up like... Yeah.
Not no epoxy thing, you know.
Unlicensed stuff.
Yeah. I'd rather do it proper. You know what I mean?
And then if you win, you're getting beat up in car park after.
Yeah. I'd rather get paid for it.
Yeah. I'll stick to the footy, man. Yeah. We'll do that. We got like a charity match for football for like TikTokers and YouTubers and that.
That's a sick idea.
Yeah. 8th of June.
Where are you playing that?
Coventry. Bebo's playing. I've got the list on my phone.
Sick.
Cal the Dragon's on there.
Oh, is he still going?
Yeah, man.
Mad Cal the Dragon.
gonna have to like take one.
Why Coventry though?
It's a guy that said.
Oh, right. So it's not used.
Yeah, they've asked us to play in it.
Right.
So
We should look at something like that for Darwin FC because they do a lot of charity football matches, and you could bring some people here.
Yeah, 100%. Like we're honestly,
they'd jump on that.
It'd be nice, like make them a bit of money, and obviously it gives chance for like the kids who love TikTok around here to come and see some of the people who they love who might not. So when you're down Coventry, get some contacts and get some signed up.
Yeah, because there's loads of northern content creators you can put together. I know there's not a lot. There's more down south, but you can get quite a few together for a footy match.
But even people from south could still come up.
The south seem to keep themselves to themselves, so, you know what I mean, when it comes to content creation. No, obviously half the time, northerns do not want to travel down south and the southerners don't want to travel up north.
Yeah, but there's not much on the north, is there? Like, in terms of all that. It's mad because like people from Preston now, like they come up to me and say, I can finally say, like, I'm not near Manchester. Preston where the Spud Bros are. So it's just like, for us, that's mad. Do you know what I mean? Mm. That's like worth everything. Do you know what I mean? Putting Preston on the map, people coming all over. And do you know what I mean? And not just like Preston, like Lancashire.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got like, we're trying to do, like Carly said, keep on top of it. Big things come in, just keep pushing and try new things and just try and smash it, like, just keep going.
So when you're not cooking spuds, what are you doing in your spare time?
Wanking.
With your glasses on.
Just had a mental thought then.
It's snorkel ham. Like I say, my girlfriend's actually pregnant, so...
Congratulations.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Spud in the oven.
A little spud in the oven.
Nice.
Gonna call it Jersey from a Jersey Royal Spud. Nah, I train boxing.
You got a good social life.
Yeah. I actually did events. So I actually DJ'd for a bit.
What events?
Kind of like raves, but not smaller raves. Yeah. But like, I did it with my two mates. We set it up. It was called Divine, actually.
Divine. Clean name.
Yeah.
What genre of music?
Tech house, bit of techno, minimal, stuff like that. Okay. But obviously I had to stop because of it was getting busier there and my mates carried on, but they're absolutely smashing it now.
Good.
Lads, yeah.
Do they make their own music?
Some of them do, yeah. Yeah, some of them.
Shall we have a listen?
If you want.
Go ahead, lad, run it.
Let me see if I can...
Have they got a track on SoundCloud or anything like that?
I'm going to see if I can get my mate's music up now.
So would you have been involved with this track if you didn't leave for Spud Bros?
I was learning how to produce, but it's different ball game producing music, and it's hard. But my mate's honestly unreal.
I can see you on stage with Maracas like Bez with them glasses on. Just giving it some vibes, bro.
Yeah, I can picture being a hype man, definitely.
Yeah.
Trust me. I've been to some house parties. You know that Jacob, that...
This one?
No. He's off his head. He's on TikTok and he always does them videos of him fucking... That one.
Oh, no, I've not seen him.
You've never seen him?
I don't think I have, actually.
Have you not? He was massive on TikTok.
Is he Australian?
He's
doesn't he?
He's from England anyway, but we've been to a few house parties with him. I was there, like, hyping him off, and he was like, yeah, bro.
Well, name this tune, and I'll find it.
Let me... It could be in my notes.
Have you not got any released? Nothing released?
I've got some of his release in a file, I think.
Oh, it's nothing on SoundCloud or Spotify?
So this is my mate Omar.
Omar, big up Omar.
Exclusive!
Oh, shit. I was just skipping it, but
that sounds clean.
Go ahead, lad.
What is that voice notes? Is that online?
Nah, it's unreleased.
But say we could have played it through the here, so we could all hear.
One of my mates set, bro. Did a tune.
We've had Morgan Seatree on the track.
Alistair, do you know Alistair
Morgan Seatree?
Yeah, he's got a few tunes on.
Morgan Seatree, remind me. Who Morgan Seatree is?
Where's he just played? Blackstone, he just played at.
My man's gone blank.
He was on Trek. There's someone called Alistair Voss from Darwin.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
I'm good mates with Alistair.
Right.
He had Taco Tuesday, didn't he?
Bro, with that track, if you send us that, we'll overlay it on this video.
It's on SoundCloud now.
All right.
Got like 2.7 million plays.
And that's a Darwin lad.
Yeah, it's a Darwin lad. Alistair Voss. Patrick Toppin's just played his tune in Melbourne.
Let's have a quick listen to that. We'll get flags. We might do.
Got a clue what you're on about here.
What's it called, that track again?
Taco Tuesday, Alistair Voss edit.
Right, get some donk on.
I know.
Was it Alistair?
Scatty members. Alistair Voss.
This one. I'll go for kicking. Hey, it's coming in now. Wait till it kicks in.
Go on, bro. Let's get some on. Moves going, table, bro.
Go on, Bill.
Show me your stuff. Woo!
Yeah, boy.
What a guy, man.
Yeah, it's a clean remix, that. Really clean.
He said to me, wait, well, how did you make Taco Tuesday? He was like, yeah, I just come home. I was absolutely fucked. And I just thought I'd just make a tune. Made it. And it got 2.7 million. Like, it blew up. Yeah.
Mad. I've heard the vocal before. Is it? Who did the original?
Migos.
Yeah. It's a big tune, man.
Yeah.
What's your, both of yours, go-to takeaway? Obviously, you got shit pizza last night.
I'm not even going to say who it is, but
I'll tell you a place where you need to go.
Go on.
Fresh and Fast.
Where's that?
Preston.
It's Preston. Yeah. Right.
We've heard that. Have people not commented that a few times? Sure I've seen that in comments.
I'm not sure.
The other one that's in Preston? That's
Tipsy
big.
Chef.
Tipsy Chef,
that's it. Closed when we went last time.
I've been Tipsy Chef, though.
Is it good?
Good.
What would you rate it?
Oh, we'll have to see, won't we?
Let's flip over.
Yeah, Jay, he's good. Makes good food, Jay.
What's this Fresh and Fast?
It's like chicken and rice. It's nothing special. It's like chicken
just
rice.
Quick
and
boxes, healthy boxes.
But they have this special sauce. So they make their own special sauce. And this special sauce is just, it's unreal.
Yeah.
I don't know what they put in it.
Yeah, they make their own like chips. Homemade chips.
Yeah.
What do we get? We get steak chicken.
Steak jerk chicken grilled, half and half. So half chips, half rice. like lettuce and shit and special sauce all over.
Yeah, it's banging. Yeah.
Right, so we're going to go to this. I want you to predict and you to predict what score he's going to give it.
What did you give us?
4.5.
Out of 5.
Yeah. And that's because there were no, that's because there were no cheese.
Yeah, you're going to have to come back.
Yeah,
we'll give you a proper
score. We'll do a rerun.
I say,
I don't know.
If you give us a 4 or 5, you
like you've got to take into consideration, I'm a little kid. Yeah.
Like chicken nuggets. Yeah. Chicken nuggets and chips.
Chicken nuggets and chips.
Shit, no, don't go there.
Nah, do they do Happy Meals?
he's the type of guy to go to India and get chicken nuggets and chips.
Nah, that's at Chinese. If I go to a Chinese buffet, I'll just get the chicken nuggets, chips,
that's
curry
standard
sauce,
though,
right?
Isn't it? I do the same.
Fairs, bro.
And I fucking can't stand Chinese buffet, me.
Do you not?
No. I think it's rotten. Do you know what puts me off?
Go on.
Yeah, the colours of Chinese restaurants, the red and gold. If I see red and gold, I'm instantly like,
fucking Scranton's red and gold.
It's not, but there's like dusty red and gold. Yeah. You know
like Chinatown
mean?
Style,
yeah,
isn't it?
It just, I get like, ooh.
Like, don't give him that red mic wire next time.
Like, go on, anyway, what was your go-to takeaway for you guys?
A meal.
In Darwin?
No, anywhere. You're number one.
Now, to be fair, Darwin have got some banging takeaways. Mm. Where we'd live, like, there was no takeaways at all, was there?
I'd say, right, Bun Fresh and Fast Off, I'd say my go-to takeaway is probably Jaffa. It's like Mediterranean food, innit?
We've had that in comments, haven't we?
Yeah.
Jaffa, yeah.
Preston again.
What's your dish?
Preston, yeah.
What's the dish?
It's basically like they do like all like chicken skewers, chicken like all like
fresh cooked chicken,
types of meats and stuff like that. They have the special sauce again, like
it's
chips, like it's unreal,
What about you, Jacob?
See, before I moved to Darwin, I never really ate a takeaway, and then Darwin's changed my life now. I'm ordering takeaways
because there's that many of them. You can't not get
spoiled for choice.
That's how we've made so much content in this town.
How many videos have we got on channel now?
200, almost 300, I think.
And 250 of them are in Darwin.
Yeah. It's weird. We don't know where the fuck they come from.
They keep popping back. They keep popping up, don't they? There's another two that we need to do.
I'm like,
it's closed down.
Fucking still in Darwin.
Yeah.
Five of course.
Number four to do.
Oh, so Darwin takeaway, what are you getting? What's your go-to?
So Golden Grill.
Yes, bro. The originator.
Do you know what I mean?
Is that still our most viewed as well?
Yeah.
Clean. You had that, didn't you? Then Sam, you came on a night out in Darwin and you got absolutely smashed and you went over there and Sam was like, that was the best takeaway ever.
Yeah?
Was that our first video?
I think so.
You give it a 3.5, you rat.
Did I?
Yeah.
No, you gave it a 4, bro. Nah, you gave it a good score.
Was it?
Yeah, nah, I remember.
Yeah, but that's back when I was a bit of a tight cunt. I didn't give a 5 out first 18 months.
Yeah. And now we've had 4 in past 5
months. I'm throwing about that. But yeah, I got Golden Grill's clean, innit? Good kebabs, man.
Yeah. Sat the pizzas off, like.
Yeah.
Apparently, is it San Remo I've got to try?
Yeah, for the pizzas.
For the pizzas. What would you say?
Al fresco for pizzas.
Oh, al fresco, that's what I meant. It's not San Remo, al fresco.
Yeah. I didn't rate al fresco when I got it.
See,
gotta give them
anything
a
else,
chance.
No, just the pizzas.
Yeah.
For me.
Cavzon's a good little all-rounder as well, I think they're pizzas.
Cavzon's nice, I like Cavzon.
But it's a nice clean place when you go in and, you know, you don't feel bad when you're getting a takeaway from there because it's quiet. Some places you go in, you feel bad before you've even ate the food.
Yeah. What's your go-to meal deal?
Tesco. What do you mean from Tesco? You won't catch me in Tesco.
Have a butty, innit?
Like, if I was going to get a little butty meal like that, it'd be a tuna mayo butty, with salt and vinegar squares. I'd have a bite of the tuna mayo butty and then a couple of squares in the same. Or just put some of the crisp on the butty, do you know what I mean? And then it'd probably be...
You're a little food connoisseur, aren't you?
I'm off up. Yeah, when it comes to chicken nuggets and chips,
What drink you rolling,
right,
though?
If you watch those videos, we've never had anything like mad, have we? It's all just been your traditional, normal food, innit?
We try and come out relatable instead of trying to...
Yeah, and that's it. And it's like how you're eating is how someone would be eating.
On a
if they're
Friday
at home,
night,
the kind of things you say, well, that's shit. That's how you'd be speaking to your missus on set. Yeah. It's not like being all posh and proper. You know what I mean?
Not sitting down with a fucking knife and fork.
Oh, I love that. It's a chicken burger.
You need to get him doing some food challenges.
We did.
We've
got one. We've got a food challenge.
Have you? What is it?
No, man versus Spud.
Go on.
It's six jacket potatoes.
Skin included.
Skin. Well, do you want the skin off?
No, you just eat. I just eat the inside,
isn't
it?
Just mash.
Yeah.
Yeah. So six jacket potatoes.
Go on.
Baby potatoes. Garlic butter on all.
And you're heavy with your butter, you guys, aren't you? You must go for some butter.
Yeah.
That's how it should be, though. Fucking good with butter.
Yes. And just like cheese. You don't like cheese?
Cheese and beans.
I don't mind cheese.
He just chat shits, ignoring me. He loves cheese.
I don't love cheese. I love mac and cheese. Yeah.
Cheese, Pete. You have cheese everything.
I like cheese when it's with something.
You like daily dunkers with cheese?
No.
Do you like cheese strings?
No.
Yes, he does. Yeah.
Baby, I've never had a cheese string in my life. Don't make me flip this pod up.
Well, the new set.
Nah, cheese. Listen, like I said, cheese, it's a weird one for me. Love pizza. Yeah. Cheese on toast, don't like. Mac and cheese, love. Just a weird one. If I can taste the cheese too much, I don't like it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just a bit crazy, weird. It's mad, isn't it? I'd have it on a spud, no messing, because there's beans and all that shit that powers over it, isn't there?
Yeah, you need to come back for another spud, man, because that was the worst spud we probably did that the entire day.
But the thing is, we do it right because we didn't tell you. A lot of places say, oh, you should have told us you were coming. So it's like authentic experience, you know what I mean?
You just picked a bad spot, a spud out, didn't you?
I think it was like, there was two left.
Yeah, there were no big ones left.
Yeah, that's what he was saying, weren't he?
And you had like the last one. Well, I think you were...
It was either the last one or a couple of them baby ones and half of the full one or something like that.
And it was like, it was slightly burnt on there. So we were just like, going to have to give it him.
Nah, it doesn't matter, man. It was still good anyway. I like it well done anyway.
Some people like it, some people don't. Controversial. Yeah.
Like, it can't be too burnt, though. It has to be like crispy.
Yeah. A bit of a crunch.
So like you can eat the skin after.
Yeah, that's it.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I like it like that. Yeah, cheese first or beans first?
Cheese.
Jesus.
Beans and then cheese on top. I've seen your video, but that's how I would have it. Because I don't like it all melted and slushy. Nah, have your cheese on top, bit of salt and pepper, away you go. Nah.
People who eat cheese on top have got six fingers.
that's Dingles.
It just sounds right to put your butter, your beans, and your cheese
on top. Yeah,
it's always been.
Yeah, but I look at it like the beans is going to melt the cheese.
I wouldn't want the cheese melted like that.
Nah, the spud, the hotness of the spud melts the bottom of the cheese and then the beans melt the top of the cheese.
Yeah, whereas I'm not...
But you get a good cheese pull then.
Yeah. And it looks better.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, no, I'm not in it for the melted cheese or the cheese pull.
I'll be honest, that's the first jacket spud I've ever had in my life. I told you that on the day.
Was it?
Were it?
I've never had a jacket spud.
Not even at school?
Ah, I used to get fucking chips and gravy.
Chicken nuggets.
Yeah, shit like that.
Turkey dinosaur.
Twizzlers before they got banned.
Oh, lads.
They get banned.
Jamie Oliver, banned.
Oh, he's a rat, isn't he?
Yeah, you can't have anything good
he's
at school
ruined
anymore.
Everyone's life.
He thinks he's made everyone go skinny, but it's done fuck all.
Yeah. Bring back the turkey Twizzlers.
That's it. Speaking of because obviously... the way we have our cheese and beans and all that, because everyone does things different in different towns or whatever. What do you call a bun with chips?
A barn.
Barm, yeah.
A chip tea cake.
It's a chip batch, unfortunately.
Batch.
It's a chip batch.
This is what I said.
A batch?
He's coming in saying, I've got your chip batch. I'm like, what's that?
What's a chip batch?
A batch.
A batch is a lot of chips in a bag. That's a batch.
No, a chip batch is a...
Like you've got a bad batch.
An easy way of putting it is like...
a batch of cookies.
Chip butty. I always say chip butty, but...
Chip butty.
Where I used to live, it's chip batch, but that's always... Like there's cob. Have you heard of cob?
Yeah. Corn of the cob.
No. It's... The cob is the buns. It's like a chip cob.
I always heard
of a chip tea cake with curry sauce.
There's so many names for him. It's nuts, isn't it?
Yeah.
But then he said tea cakes and them chocolate things.
Tea cake
and balm, like bread, isn't it?
Yeah, tea cake's
the one, the little mad one with the white tea in it, isn't it?
That's a hot cross bun.
<that one. laughs>
You get chocolate tea cakes.
Yeah, current tea cakes. And anyway, the fruit in and...
No, the one with the mousse and the strawberry in the middle. Yeah, chocolate on the outside of the tea cake as well.
Scone, isn't it?
No, he's on about them little... little red box. Tunnett's tea cake.
Yeah, that's it.
Bollocks to him. It's a chip butty.
Chip batch. People knew when you said chip batch.
They were going mad for a chip batch though in the comments. It was mad.
Miller knows what it is, but then people were like, what the fuck's a tea cake?
Majority were chip butty though.
Yeah, that's like the default, isn't it, really?
Yeah.
Butter, because you can put ham butter.
And then people comparing like bread to tea cakes and that. It's all the same thing, and it's all bread.
Yeah. Well, we can confirm that it's chip batch.
Chip
batch. Yeah.
Nice. I disagree, but we move.
Chip batch.
What about a spud batch?
What, spud butty?
Yeah, they do the Wigan kebab. We could have the spud kebab.
Spud butty, yeah.
That's a shout, that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Something spud to try.
Should we try it?
We try it.
I'll do a TikTok on it.
Yeah.
See what happens.
We'll call it the Scran Time Spud Butty.
Yeah, the Scran Time Spud Batch.
Yeah. Scran Time Special. Let's go.
Yeah, something like that.
In my observation since the last podcast, one thing that's been like, what do they say, grinding my gears, is like, why do people shave in gym?
What?
You don't think it's mad? Have you never seen anybody shaving it? Not actually while they're lifting weights, but like, so you go to gym, you go to changing rooms after, and it's usually older people. They're in the sink, shaving foam on, top off, towel round, having a full on shaving gym,
yeah,
bro.
I know why this is, bro.
But why is mad?
I know exactly how this is, yeah. He I seen this it, on the internet right, the other day. So what people in motorhomes do, yeah? They pay the £30 a month to shower instead of paying for something else. I can't think what they pay for.
Just the gym.
Nah, they pay for the membership to have the showers and shit every day instead of paying for the fees of the parking and that. Then you get your shower in like the lorry parks or the places right, where they fucking park. Yeah. They pay for gym memberships £30 a month and they all shower and shit in there every day.
And have off a clean shave. Yeah. Like,
so that's
like
what men. Some people, if it's the older people, it will be. That's
lorry drivers
doing,
and stuff.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah.
Just a blag, mate, isn't it?
I didn't know that, but that's what I heard the other day, mad.
So are you in Darwin Leisure seeing people shave while you're just chilling or?
No, full not, works, lad,
yeah, not while we're lifting weights, but like if I go and get my bag out locker after, or I'll have a slash and wash my hands, the guy next to me is there.
Shaving
foam on, towel round.
Can you imagine if you walked
full clean
in,
shave.
Shaving his
bum. Mate, where did me and my missus were in sauna, there was someone shaving in sauna. Yeah, that'd be a bit too much if leg were up on it. Give it ball bag a quick trim.
Mirror that.
It's mad, isn't it?
Another, so I'll piss you off then.
What?
That people shaving in.
No, it doesn't piss me off. It's just mad, like, it's why weird, though? Yeah. I'd have a shave at home in private, not like fucking full on. You know what I mean? It's a bit mad.
Yeah, fuck that.
I'm just trying to understand why people.
Don't shave near VJ. You
yeah. Shave at home behind closed doors. Another one, what I'm thinking of, like red flags. When did red flag become a thing? Like birds or whoever saying, oh, that's a massive red flag. Like, where's red flag come from? And like, how many red flags is too many red flags? Like,
there's
fucking hell, lad. What's not a red flag now?
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Have you seen that guy on TikTok?
Yeah, when he brings that list up, he's got about 400 and odd.
I think he's about 1,000, man. This guy just sees a video of someone saying, oh, yeah, he's a walking red flag if this and that. And then he just goes, boom, goes over to his nose and says, bro, that's a red flag. Why have you got red flag lit?
No, did your missus do that?
Did she?
Yeah, shit, she did. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Should we ring her now and see what my red flags are?
Go on.
Nah. I'm about to get beaten
out. But
it's
mad
though,
isn't it? It's mad, like, when was that a thing? It's only recent, isn't it?
Yeah, I seen one on TikTok of a week, and it's the guys that are interviewing the birds in the street and that, when they're on nights out and that, and he's like, what's your red flag? And she's like, if a guy's wearing a seatbelt in car.
Yeah.
he pulls that list up, boom, flips out, right now, bottom of the list. It's just everything in life you can't do now.
That is
crap. That and X.
Yeah, we said this last time.
Things, innit? The similar things, like.
Weird.
The stupidest things just give you the ick and that. It's like, oh, man. It doesn't
it's
that.
Funny, though.
Yeah, it is.
It's mad. There were one I seen some birds on holiday with a fella, and they're in sea swimming with sharks or something, and she's put a new ick unlocked. She's filming him from behind. He's got this fucking life. Have you seen it? He's got this life jacket on that goes over his ass. He's just paddling away. New ick unlocked, man.
That is funny, man. To be fair.
They're all mad, aren't they?
They are. So on TikTok, who's the creators that you've got your eyes on? Not eyes on, but who do you like enjoy watching?
My TikTok's mad.
Yeah, Scran Time. No, to be fair, I actually used to watch you before I even did the TikTok.
I watch you all the time now. You're funny.
Respect.
You are funny, bro.
Yeah, and like, I think when you're like, I think when you commented, I think someone, did you comment on a video?
I think
I commented, didn't I?
Yeah, and yeah.
Like, you commented back. I was fucking buzzing, man. I was like, yeah, let's get scrum time, man.
Yeah, yeah. Sick.
We came over, I think, about a week after you commented, thought, man, we're going over.
Yeah, yeah. But I don't know, like, yeah, I don't know. We just, to be honest, we don't really, we do the content, we post it.
You're not wanting to scroll through.
It's sort of like a case of you're on it all day. So when you get home, it's like, you've been on it all day anyway. So you want to have a little break.
Like replying back to people and like the messengers and all that. I do that. Like, but the comments and all that just can't be arsed with it. Yeah. Like, just because it's just hard work.
There's a lot in it.
Yeah. But I can't sit there on TikTok just like scrolling.
Yeah, but that's a full, like when people are really big, that's a full-time job to someone, a social media person, right? You handle all that, reply to all my comments, and then you've got to do it as you're doing everything else as well. So it becomes a bit of a blag. Yeah.
I like the feed review. Is like, feed review is like my hashtag's funny. Like I like it. Like, you need to go do some
funny.
You and him together, man.
That'd like, be
you
nuts. Need to do
some... Who's your favorite food reviewer? He's off his
tits, isn't he? Who's your favorite food reviewer?
Scranton Miller, man.
Yeah.
No, it actually is though. Like,
yeah, man.
Darwin, innit? So got to look after each other.
That's it. Hashtag, it is funny, man.
Listen, we'll just get better and better as we go on anyway, won't we? Do you know what I mean? The comment will swap and change.
Exactly.
And different things will happen. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's like it does with anyone.
Yeah, exactly, man. It's like, you got to, I don't know, TikTok's weird though. You got to like follow the trend a bit as
That's
well.
That's it.
You
know what I mean? Yeah.
Like when a new trend happens, I'm like, Mil, I've got this. He's like, no. He's like, no.
Fucking comes in, man. He's got me doing all sorts of shit.
I wanted to do this. He's like, nah, I'm not a TikToker.
Yeah, no.
I don't want to be that guy that does the trends. Do you know what I mean? I want to do the thing that we're doing. I don't want to be like doing these dances and that we used to do.
I want him to do the dances.
Because you can just sit back and fucking laugh like everyone else that watches it. You know what I mean?
You just want to be yourself.
That's it. Yeah. I just do what we do and... That's Sorry, it.
Cut you up then, bro. I did love the ones you did outside though, when you got the lead falling with that little bit of acting and that tripping over. They were good. They were good then.
That was the cleanest trip.
And
sometimes I look back and think that was not on purpose. That was
acted. Yeah, everybody said it before.
It was that good. This trip, you'd think everyone's laughing. I'm doing look at you now, blah blah blah.
No, Ben, you fell over.
We out there. We went out
front. Yeah.
And I said to him before it, I was like, I'll pretend to fall over, and I fucking nailed it.
Excuse me. What were you listening to?
Mate, don't fucking touch me.
Oh, sorry,
it's a banger, but yeah, I don't want to be doing them little dances.
Yeah, you can do like
I'll do the odd one that's funny and we'll put our own spin on it, like the one when we went in booth and that. Like I don't mind doing that.
The drink one as well you did that we incorporated that. Where you were pouring the drink.
You.
Oh yeah, you remember that guy on tip? You seen that guy where he's like posh and he's got a wine glass? And that song in the background
that we got flagged for.
Yeah. And he just gets it and looks at it. Swigs it and then just shakes the hand to the person just served him. Have you not seen it?
No, not seen that.
I think he's like German or something. But
nah, he's Italian, isn't he? I think he's mad Italian or something like that.
Yeah, wine and that.
Yeah,
it's like a wine connoisseur. And I buzz off at me. That's why we did it on the Scrum Time. Just took piss a little bit.
But you got yourself swilled.
I did, lad.
About time I got you with something though, isn't it?
Bastard, man.
Quality.
One last thing, because I'm curious about.
He's got a smile on his face.
No, this is just for
personal. Bank balance.
It's nothing about shaving or red flags. Something random again, but like, what is your go-to trainer, your best trainer of all time? Each and every person around this table, think about it for a second and hit me with one trainer that you
trainer,
sneaker, footwear. Runner,
oh, right.
Footwear, yeah.
Trainees.
I don't know.
You got to pick one.
Probably just the.
And when you say it, Mike is going to ping a picture up of each person's and then the people in the comments can say who's picked the best trainer.
I probably would the Jordans.
Yeah? What, standard threes, Jordan. Fours?
I don't know what they are.
Just Jordans.
Yeah, just but not them ones, not the high tops, the low tops.
Yeah.
Jordan 1 Low.
Colour?
I've got some like white, black and yellow ones at home.
Nice.
Like the yellow.
Proper little techno house numbers.
A lot, two stepper shoes.
It is.
Go on, Jacob.
I live in my Crocs, man. Yeah. I ain't got them on today, but I live in my Crocs. They have some But in terms of trainers, I gotta go for 97s, I think. It's just all black, ultra black.
Clean.
Yeah.
Legendary. Miller.
TN's all day long, brother.
Colour. You
wearing TN's? Smoky lad. Yeah?
Go on, bro.
Like, we was having a conversation the other day about them, weren't we? We sent so many pictures of TNs to each other and like, they're just all class.
Normal lads are sending pictures of tits and he's like, TNs.
Yeah. Isn't it though, like,
yeah, we do.
You think, oh, they don't look good, but then you think, ah, I can you pull them off, what, you know what I mean? I see them in person, they're right. I just think every pair of TNs is clean.
Fair 110s TNs.
Yeah. And I just think TN's a solid trainer as well. Last you fucking years if you look after them right. Do you know what I mean?
What are you going with, Mike?
The classic white Air Force Ones all day, man. Yeah,
legendary.
If I could, you know, keep them clean, I already own like two or three pairs of white Air Force Ones, but they just don't last because I don't look after any of them.
Yeah.
The creasing as well that does
it's with white, one little bit of dust or dirt, then the colours never the same.
Well, that's it. You know, fucking bend of the toes and that's it. Mm. Creased up, but yeah, go on, V.
I do love TNs, as you can see, and I like 95s as well, or 110s, but my all-time favourite trainer of all time is an Air Jordan 6 Infrared Black.
Jeez.
Which I've...
Oh, specific black.
Yeah. Okay, he's buzzing.
I'm buzzing because I've literally just acquired some not long ago.
So. Oh, is it them yourself?
Yeah.
How much?
Yeah. No, there were no price on it.
What's your bank balance?
Basically, to buy them trainers is 500.
Yeah.
But I didn't buy them. I got them gifted.
Ooh.
So.
You robbed them.
But I don't wear many trainers often. I'll wear them maybe on the... I was going to wear them today, but we've got the tables. If it were couches, I'd be there. But yeah, we'll ping the pictures up of everyone's and then in the comments, let us know who's got the best footwear.
Right, boys. So... It's been a pleasure having you down.
Yeah, definitely. It's
been a pleasure, man.
Thank you.
Good lads, you, man.
Yeah.
100%.
Top lads, and we love what you're doing. We hope this carries on, the whole Spud crew carries on, man.
Yeah.
And we'll definitely come down and see you again. Mm-hmm. And up to work with you as well. We'd like to, if you ever want to start your own podcast, you know where to come and ask us.
We need to get him serving Spuds.
Now, yeah, so what that's the plan. We're going to get some people like actually serve, because on TikTok...
What, you want me to do a fucking 8-hour day?
We'll pay you in chicken nuggets.
Nah, I'd do it, man. I'd do it for a laugh, yeah.
No, until you're just like, fuck this, I'm not doing this.
Yeah. Probably after 5 minutes. Yeah. Yeah. One more Spud. Can I be on my fucking hell? I'm going to lose my head.
Yeah, we'll get Miller in. Yeah,
man.
You can imagine that. Yeah. Get us another Spud lad. Fucking another one.
That'll be a good episode, to be fair. That'll be a good one, that.
Yeah, and I just want to say as well, obviously, some people might think you're lucky to be where you are, like, and TikTok's all luck, but everything you've got is down to you two guys, because like we've all said, you're both sick and you deserve everything. You deserve everything, what you've got, and long may it continue for you both.
Thank you very much.
All 3 years.
Yeah?
What do you say? It's the
apple
he said.
Yeah. No. He's a good lad. He works hard.
We all work hard, man. It's good to see.
He'll have his own sport, man, soon. If you carry on working, he'll have his own.
Oh yeah,
one.
Go on. No, you're right. Go on.
What's up, Mel?
I was just going to ask about this new Spud fan that you've got coming in. When's that dropping?
June.
And that's going where that one is now.
Yeah.
And what's happening with this one that you've got?
That's going to be for events.
Oh, cool, man.
All right.
Nice.
Yeah. Festivals, events. We might do Spud Bros on tours, you
Sick.
Know.
That'd
nice.
Be cool, man.
Yeah.
Do a little like driving podcast, you know.
Yeah, man. See, like, thinking work ahead, man.
You boys are on it,
Yeah, man. All right, people. So we're going to leave the Spud Bros information all in the description. Just go and check them out. It won't be hard to find. They're everywhere. So, boys, thank you again.
Thank nice you one. Very much for having us.
Thank you, thank you. Right, I'll see you all in the next one.
Peace.
Cheese, chili, beans and tuna. I want it now, but I need it sooner. Don't be da. Good mama, I sit back, kick back. What potatoes da? Potatoes this, potatoes that. Potatoes good, potatoes fat. One's one way you coming back, listen to the hottest potato rap. Get your Spuds, hot potato chips, Spud Bros. PR4 baby, no, where are we? PR3.
Get your Spuds in.
Get your Spuds in, lad.
No, nah. Yes, lad. This is the Flexed Podcast with Mikey, VJ, and Miller. What you kicking off for? No holding back, ting. Bang.